Hey, what's up everyone? A question that I get a lot is, how much money do you need to start flipping houses? The answer is, the more money you have, the more flexibility you have. But even if you don't have any money to invest in the deal, you can still start flipping houses today. And let me show you how. I'm going to break down the entire house flipping process and show you every step that requires money and how much money you will need and where you can get the money from. Before we dive in further, I want to briefly introduce myself. I'm a house flipper in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I was laid off from my plush tech job 2.5 years ago and started flipping houses full time. I've been flipping 7 to 8 houses a year, and 2019 was my first 7-figure profit year. The first step, before you can submit an offer on a house to flip, you'll need a proof of funds. The proof of funds needs to cover the entire purchase price, and it can be a bank statement, stock portfolio, or even a retirement account. If you don't have any of these, you can get a pre-approval letter from either a mortgage broker or a hard money lender. I've talked about the difference between a mortgage broker and a hard money lender. The main difference is how they qualify you. A mortgage broker qualifies you based on your income, and a hard money lender qualifies you based on your asset. When you are flipping houses, the hard money lenders look at the deal as your asset. If you have a solid deal, they would be willing to lend money to you. If you have a good W-2 income, then you have the option to go with a mortgage broker to fund your flip. But if you don't have a good W-2 income, then a hard money lender would be your best bet. And check out this video to learn everything about hard money. Step number 2, offer acceptance. That's when you'll have to put up the earnest money deposit, EMD. It's usually 3% of the total purchase price, and you have to put it in escrow within 3 days of offer acceptance. I flip houses in the San Francisco Bay Area, and home prices here are one of the highest in the country. So if you could fund your flips in the Bay Area, you probably have enough money to fund a flip anywhere else in the US. So I'm going to use my local numbers as an example to give you an idea. On average, the acquisition price for my flips is $1 million, so I'm going to use that number as an example. On a $1 million purchase price, a 3% EMD is $30,000. If you are a beginner in house flipping, I recommend that you at least know where the EMD is going to come from before you start looking for deals. Because once your offer is accepted, you have only 3 days to put up the EMD. You have many options to put together the $30,000. It could be from a credit card, or a home equity line of credit, HELOC, or from a retirement account. If you don't have any of these sources available to you, you can also borrow money from friends and family or a private money lender. Private money lenders are usually wealthy individuals who are interested in growing their investment safely and quickly. Real estate is a great place for private money lenders because their investments are much safer than in the stock market, and the interest rate they can charge would be a lot higher than what they get from the bank. If you want to learn where to find these private money lenders, check out this video. Step number 3, contingency period. This is when you are in contract to purchase the house, but you can still back out anytime without any consequences. This period usually lasts anywhere from 0 to 17 days. When you make an offer without any contingencies, that means your contingency period is 0. So you cannot back out of the contract without any legal consequences, and your earnest money deposit is hard from day one. But if you have a property contingency, a financing contingency, or a loan contingency, up to 17 days, that's when you can still back out of the contract and get your EMD back. If you have a good contingency period in the contract, then you can look for another investor to wholesale the contract to without having to put any more money in the deal or any work into the house, but still make a good profit. If you want to learn how to wholesale a house, check out this video. If you decide to go through with the purchase yourself without wholesaling the contract, then you would want to continue with the house flipping process. Step number 4, close on the purchase. Of course, you could use all your own funds to cover the entire purchase price, but $1 million is a lot. As we mentioned earlier, you could choose to use a conventional loan or a hard money loan to cover up to 80 to 90% of the purchase price. Then you would only need to worry about the 10 to 20% of the purchase price, which is $100,000 to $200,000. Right now, in July 2020, with the pandemic going on, many hard money lenders have tightened their lending criteria and their funding guidelines. The hard money lenders that I usually work with have reduced their funding from 90% of the purchase price to up to 85% of the purchase price, and the rates have gone up slightly too. So for the 10 to 20% of the purchase price, if you don't have your own funds, you can still use a HELOC or borrow from friends and family or a private money lender. When you close on the purchase of the house, you also have to take into account the closing costs. If you are a beginner paying 10% and 2 points to hard money lenders, and you are borrowing 90% of the purchase price, so $900,000 on a $1 million home, then you're paying 2 points, $18,000 at the close of purchase. The closing costs also include insurance, title costs, and transfer taxes, and those are usually a few thousand dollars. Step number 5, construction. That's when you need to fund the renovations on the flip. On average, I spend about $100,000 on my renovations. Some hard money lenders offer to fund 100% of the construction loan, but it has to be a really good deal because the total loan amount has to be less than 70 to 75% of the after repair value. The construction loan is usually held back until part of the work is completed, and then you request an inspection. If the inspection is satisfied, then the lender will reimburse you the funds. So there are some drawbacks with the construction loan. Contractor payments can be delayed, and the points or origination fee of the construction loan is actually charged upfront, so it can be a little expensive. As soon as you own the house, you have to start paying hard money interest or mortgage interest. Again, assuming you have a loan of $900,000, then every month at 10% interest, you are paying $7,500. Once you own the house and during construction, you also have to pay for utilities. Step number 6, for sale. That's when you put the house on the market for sale after construction. To get your house ready for sale, you have to pay for staging, photography, and inspections. Staging in my area usually costs a few thousand dollars, and photography is very reasonable, usually just a couple hundred dollars. Inspections usually cost a few hundred dollars, no more than $1,000. Even after you put the house on the market for sale, during the entire sale process, you still have to continue paying hard money and mortgage interest and utilities until the sale is closed. As I've shown you here, it takes a sizable investment to flip houses. But every step of the way, you have many options to fund the project, and you don't have to always use your own money. If you enjoyed this episode, click the like button below and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. See you next week.